We're going into the 11th day of the month of Elul. Now we're going to step it up a little bit in the effort of tshuva. So we're just going to conclude now all the main titles that we went through, the original list that we created in the first or second day to Elul, which if you didn't make the list and you want to participate, you can make the list whenever you want. But the earlier you do it, the more you're able to focus on. Yesterday we were focusing on yesterday and the day before about disappointments from high expectations and gratitude for when Hashem and other people come through. Now we're concluding by me having disappointments for myself. And on the same level also that I'm surprising myself, so to say. That usually doesn't happen. It's usually the disappointments. You made yourself a resolution. You made a achlata. From this day on, I'm going to do this. And it lasted 3 days. Now, some people don't care. Some people take it very hard. Why can I do it? What kind of a human being I am? What type of a Eved Hashem? What kind of a service I do to Hashem? I promised Hashem I'll do this and that. I can't even do it. What's going on with me? I mean, how many times you make conditions with Hashem? I don't know about you. I make conditions sometimes. Hashem, at least I made it when I became observant. If you're going to do this and this, I'm going to do this and that. If you help me get this job, again, I remember when I first became observant, there was a certain apartment that I wanted. I told Hashem, if you help me get this apartment, if you're making a miracle, I'm taking on myself that I'm going to do achnasat ochim. I'm going to host people in my home. And, you know, Hashem made a miracle. Bemet, I got it. It was against all odds. I didn't have good credit. I didn't have whatever they wanted, I didn't have. And somehow I got this beautiful, gorgeous apartment. And so I said, okay. So Hashem, I promise you, now I have to do achnasat ochim. So many times you do a condition with Hashem and you don't fulfill what you're supposed to do. Now, when you're dealing directly with Hashem or other people where you promise and there's expectations, that's one thing. Now we're going to focus on the times that I decided to do something and I failed and I become very disappointed in myself. So first of all and most important, this is not going to apply to everybody. Some people can care less. Some people will make a decision, a resolution, a hachlata. It lasts 3 days, a week, whatever, and they can care less. Ah, whatever. It's too much for me right now. Most people forget. And there are a few auspicious times in the year that you take on yourself decisions. Some people do it on their birthday, and many people do it. Rosh Hashanah, Yom Kippur, Sukkot, auspicious times that they say, you know what, I'm gonna take on myself. I'm gonna start showing up to the minyan every day. I'm gonna start learning an hour a day. I'm gonna say Birkat Hamazon, wash my hands and say the blessing after. I'm gonna start saying brachot for the eating with a better kavanah. I'm going to start saying the last bracha. I know that 90% of observant Jews don't even bother to say the last bracha after they eat and drink. I'm talking about the observant ones, not the ones who are not that are secular. How many people really remember to say Borei Nefeshot Rabot? I never see it, and I know that most people don't do it, which is a more important bracha than the first one. So sometimes you're saying, you know, I'm going to take on myself A, B, and C, and then you don't do it. Now, I don't know about you, I get very disappointed in myself. What, you can't hold the decisions you made? First of all, and most important as a side note, you have to be very careful that you're doing it without a vow. When you're saying, Bli Neder, I'm going to try my best. I'm going to give it the best shot I can. If you don't say Bli Neder, you might find yourself in a problem and you lock yourself in a vow by saying, I'm going to start doing this. And then you took it, once you said it in your mouth, and if you didn't include Bli Neder without a vow, then you're going to have a problem. And this is another thing we need to talk about. This will do more towards the end of Elul, is how we start doing tshuva for our vows. If you're looking at the list, we say in Slichot and in Yom Kippur, is that we say in Slichot, I don't know about the Ashkenazi Slichot, in Sephardi Slichot, we say about vows that I took and I didn't do, about promises that I said and I didn't fulfill. This is a big deal. People don't understand. Sometimes the severe sins is not just killing somebody. Sometimes it's you say something with your mouth and you don't fulfill it. So taking a vow and not doing it, that's a big, big deal. We're going to talk about it more towards the end of Elul. Because the ones of you who remember on at the end of Elul, some people do it in the morning of Rosh Hashanah, different ones, you do Atarat Nedarim. Usually we do it in the morning of Rosh Hashanah. Some people do it in the morning of Yom Kippur. I mean, in Yom Kippur we start with Kol Nidrei. Kol Nidrei is Atarat Nedarim, is a nullification of the vows. This is when women, that they don't do Atarat Nedarim, that they have to come on Yom Kippur to hear Kol Nidrei. But nevertheless, many women also come, they do Atarat Nedarim. Why not? So, going back to, just to focus on our topic, if you don't get disappointed from goals that you set yourself and you didn't fulfill it, then this class is not for you. And I may recommend to start taking notice to things like this. And by the way, I'm not only talking about that I take on myself good decisions in Torah and mitzvot. Sometimes it says, you know what, I'm going to start being more attentive to the needs of my kids. I'm going to be a little bit more soft-speaking with my wife. We have something that we do, a custom that we do in our house every now and then, that we gather the family members, and each one in their turn say their concerns, things that they don't like, things that they appreciate. And even my four-year-old will say, I don't like when you talk to me like this, I don't like when you do this. Yeah, everybody, spit it out, put it on the table, let's see what's the problem. And the trick here is to listen. And if somebody tells me, I don't like how you talk to me, or I don't like how you treat me, or whatever, it's not to say, yeah, but you know, and you start. No, there's no reactions here, you're just listening. So many times, the decisions you take on yourself is not, okay, I'm going to show up to the minyan. Is, you know what, I'm going to treat my wife a little bit nicer. You know what, I'm going to talk with a little bit more respect to my workers. Some people, they don't talk with respect to their employees. So even that is a decision that you take, and what if you didn't fulfill it? So again, like I told you, a nice amount of people can care less. Whatever. So I'm referring to the ones, if you can care less, that's not good. You have to bring it into your system that you should care when you decide to do something or you set yourself a goal and you didn't. I get very disappointed. I'm very hard on myself. What, I decided to do this, I can't do that. Now, the important thing here is not to be so hard on yourself that you start falling into sadness, depression, despair, you give up, and it's not good to bash yourself too much on your head. But nevertheless, you have to take a moment, better to take maybe 10 moments or 10 minutes or an hour, and to think, okay, what did I took on myself as a achlata, a resolution to do, and I didn't do it. Now, first of all, why didn't I do it? Was I lazy? Was it too much? I took too many things at the same time. You have to analyze, why don't I do it? To understand, maybe what's the deficiency here? Is this maybe it's just laziness? Maybe I forgot. Maybe I was drunk. You know, sometimes when you're drunk, I'm going to start coming to the minyan every day. And then you forget, you were drunk, or whatever it is. The point is to try to reflect as much as you can. Most people not necessarily will remember, but to try to reflect as much as you can, what did I decide to take on myself in any type of a department and I didn't do it? And how am I rectifying that? Being disappointed, that's the beginning. That should be the trigger, that should be the motivation to, okay, now I have to change something. But how do you change something? Is that you initiate either the same decisions or others and you start. So Elul is a very good time to say, okay, last year, I remember, I said I'm gonna take on myself A, B, and C, and it didn't last. It lasted 3 weeks, or a month, or a week, or a day. So you want to, if you can, if you remember, make a list. And then say, on one side, why wasn't I able to do it? And to analyze, maybe it was just being lazy. Maybe it just didn't work out. Maybe I decide to go every Wednesday to a certain class and something came up, my wife goes to the class and I have to babysit the kids. Okay, so that's it. Not that I didn't want to. So let me take something maybe on a Thursday. The point, to make a long story short, is to understand that on the month of Elul, you can rectify much, much easier. So this is the time when you say, okay, whatever I took on myself and I wasn't able to fulfill, let me do it on the month of Elul. So I know, I mean, this is more applicable for a person that really works on themselves. A lot of people, they don't care if they have any spiritual growth or if they have any refinement of their own character. If a person is in that level, this doesn't really apply to them. But a person that constantly wants to grow spiritually and refine themselves, this should be in the front line of their head. Where am I failing? I know exactly what I took on myself in the previous years, what I was able to be good with, and what I was able to what I was failing. So on Elul, I look at the ones that I failed, and then I make sure that I do it throughout the month of Elul. Better to do it even till Yom Kippur. Why? Again, to get it into the system. So, and each one has their own decision. Sometimes for a person, it's something very, very minor. Like you said before, saying the brachot with more intention, saying the actual brachot. Better always to take these small decisions than to some people, you know, they're 3 days they're observant. I'm going to start observing Shabbat. Oh, you just started, figured out that you are a Jew. Suddenly you want to observe Shabbat. Relax, take it easy. How about you start with a few easy things? Not good to start with the ones that you know you're gonna fail. Many times I talk to people and I tell them, I guide them, I think you should start doing A, B, and C. No, that's too small. I want to start doing a few big things. You're not going to be able to do it. It's going to last a week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, and you're going to fail. And I became observant. I got very, very excited. So maybe a month after my personal experience, I started walking with a yarmulke. I was so excited in the beginning to walk with a yarmulke, and it lasted like 4 days. Because sometimes I went to certain places, it was embarrassing, so I took the yarmulke off. And it bothered me. You know, in the beginning, it bothers you, something on your head all day long. So it lasted maybe 3 or 4 days. And somebody told, one of my friends told me, what, that's it? You were religious for 4 days? I said, no, I'm not ready for the yarmulke. So for me, that was a huge thing, to put something on my head. I was religious in the heart, as they say. The point is that you want to follow through. You want to make sure that when you're making a decision, you're actually doing it. Now is the time to reflect, why didn't you do it? Why did you fail? Why did it last only a week or two? Make yourself a certain, some type of analysis. Analyze why it didn't work. And then again, you want to put yourself a few goals that are not so hard, that you're saying the entire month of Elul, better to drag it till Yom Kippur, and if you can drag it till Hoshana Rabbah, even best, that's when everything is sealed. And you say, by hook or by crook, or I don't know how you say it in other terms in English. In Israel we say, Beras bin Immo, that's the man of the world, will turn upside down. This I'm not missing. And you make sure that you're fulfilling this decision, and you're saying, Bli Nedel, I'm going to try till Hoshana Rabbah every day to wash my hands when I'm eating. I'm going to say Birkat HaMazon. I'll read Tikkun HaKlali. I will make sure that I'm saying the right bracha with the right intention and making the bracha chona, whatever. And you want to make as many of these as possible because A, I know, again, it sounds like you're cheating the game, but you're impressing Hashem. Here, I'm doing tshuva. I'm trying to rectify what I didn't do 11 months. But besides impressing Hashem, you're bringing it into the system. If you do something repetitively, 40 days, 2 months, whatever, it becomes part of you. So even if 20-30% falls, then the rest is remaining. A lot of the things that we do in practicing religion is doing it in a very recurring way, every day, every day, every day. Why? So it becomes a system. In one way, it's not good because it becomes a habit, and you're doing it, what's called anashim elumada. You're just doing it like a robot. That's not good. But nevertheless, you still need to get it to your system. When you get something into your system, it is easier to later on refine it. So a lot of people say, listen, I'm not doing it with the right intention. Okay, so our sages say, do it without intention. Why? Mitoch shelo lishma, yavo lishma. By doing it for not the right, for the right intention, and not having any intention, but you start doing it, then we'll go to the next level that you start bringing some soul into it, some life into it. So dafka now, in the month of Elul, you want to reflect. First of all, you want to have some disappointment in yourself. How wasn't I able to fulfill these a few little things that I put to myself? I don't make lists like this only in Elul. On my table, you'll see is the lists. Because at the end of the day, the end of the week, whatever, I look at the list, check, check, check. It's in the front of my face. I have all these little lists that I do. Why? Because it's constantly keeping me okay. I have a schedule. I have what to follow through, and I highlight it, highest priority, less priority, not so important. And then the next day rolls over to the next day, Yeah, you try to work in an organized way, not only in my tshuva, in my day to day. So especially when it comes to the tshuva, you want to go backwards the whole year and say, why was I failing? Because of A, B, and C. Okay, now let me change it. And you want to take on yourself at least, that's at least my recommendation, 20, 30 things that you're taking on yourself to fulfill in the next 40 days. Now, again, I'm not talking about reading two books of Tehillim every day. Don't take this on yourself. It will take you 4 hours to do it. But to say the after bracha, after you eat, that's a pretty simple thing. It takes you 3.5 seconds to say that. You just have to have it in your mind to say it and not forget. Take on yourself things that are easy, chick, like that. But you do it as a system. So read Tikkun HaKlali every day. Okay, some people tell me, I don't know how to read Hebrew. It takes me 40 minutes. Okay, so do something else. To me, it takes 6-7 minutes. 6-7 minutes is nothing. On the way from here to there, read it as you're walking. But you want to take on yourself as much as little things that you pay attention to, because you get it into the system. And even if 20%, 30% remain after that, you still gained a lot. So, Mezal Hashem, now is the time. If you remember the first day I told you, Rosh Chodesh Elul Hashem gave us a coupon, a 99% coupon that is valid for 40 days. Use the coupon for whatever you want. Anything you'll do in Torah and Mitzvot, 99% off. Just grab it. So whatever you take on yourself now, it's filling all the void that was missing the entire year for 11 months, and 11 months backwards. And with that, Bezalel Hashem, you are able to focus more on your tshuva, and needless to say, to fulfill the decision that you make. The point is that all these decisions that you make, they're taking you from one level to another level to another level. Just remember when you became observant. Some people, for them, it's their first month of being observant. For me, when I became observant, every little thing was like huge. Even just to to do something small was to focus on it. Wait a minute, am I doing it right? After 20 years, it comes like automatic. But just remember how much effort had to go into every little act when you first started. So, same thing here. The more you bring it into the system, then it becomes part of you. You know, when I became observant also, when I was in yeshiva, that was already a later stage of me becoming observant, then I took on myself all these things. I would read every day, Shir HaShirim, Perek Shira, Nishmat Kol Chai, Tikkun HaKli, all these little things. But I found the right times when to read it, it was part of the system. So I used to read, for example, every day Perek Shira. So it would take me a certain amount of time from the yeshiva home to walk. I would read it as I'm walking home. So that was my, don't disturb me. Somebody will see me on the street. I can't talk. Why? It takes me 7 minutes to go from here to here. That's when I'm reading it. So I would make myself these times a day. And you know, it became part of the system. So not only that became part of the system, first of all, it became already, I knew it off by heart. You know what it is to say it every day for years? I already can mumble it. Blah, 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 blah. So first of all, that's already good, becoming very polished in your system. Better to have this stuck in your head than all sorts of songs, all sorts of lines for movies. Some people remember one lines for movies and they'll say it at their appropriate time. Better to have mishnayot and all sorts of psukim stuck in your head. Besides the fact that you have a certain repetitive system, and it elevates you. Because we have a mitzvah that constantly we have to have Hashem in front of me. Shiviti Hashem l'negdi tamid. Constantly I have to have Hashem in my mind. How do you do that? When you're constantly busy with little things. And that's how you spiritually elevate yourself. Needless to say, you're able to rise to a much higher level of tshuva. And that's what we want to focus on in the month of Elul, so I can come into Rosh Hashanah in a much higher spiritual altitude to be able to be blessed on Rosh Hashanah with an abundance of health and happiness and success and for my wishes to come true. Why? Not because Hashem wants to give me more or less, because the capacity is greater for me to hold. Hashem wants to give me is much more than what I can handle, but He can only give me what I prepare. I have a vessel to prepare. Elul is when I prepare it. If not, Hashem can give me more than what I can handle. Hashem says, if you can only hold 100 kilos, I only give you 100 kilos. If you can hold this amount, I'll give you this amount. So Elul, you're expanding the vessel. How? With these little things that you're saying, okay, I'm going to do it for 40 days now, consecutive. So I know we're already in the 11th of Elul. So drag it till after Sukkot. But stick with the 40 days. 40 days is the chazakah to get something into the system. You fight for 40 days, you'll see after 40 days it's already part of the system. Bezal Hashem, with that, we're not only going to be able to expand our spiritual vessel, but also to get a much greater blessing from the Kadosh Baruch Hu and be blessed with a sweet and happy new year.